The Three Century Woman by Richard Peck. The cameraman pulled in for a tighter shot. The anchor seemed to search his mind. You could tell he thought he was a great interviewer, though he had no sense of humor. A tiny smile played around great-grandma's wrinkled lips. "But you've lived through amazing times, Mrs. Breckenridge, and you never think back about them?" Great-grandma stroked her chin and considered. "You mean you want to hear something interesting? Like how I lived through the San Francisco earthquake, the big one of 06? Beside me, Mom stirred. We were crowded over by the dead lady's bed. "You survived the 1906 San Francisco earthquake," the anchor said. Great-grandma gazed at the ceiling, lost in thought. "I'd have been about 7 years old. My folks and I were staying at that big hotel, you know the one. I slept in a cot at the foot of their bed. In the middle of the night, that room gave a shake, and the chiffonier walked right across the floor. You know what a chiffonier is?" "A chest of drawers," the anchor said. "Close enough," Great-grandma said, and the pictures flapped on the walls. We had to walk down 12 flights because the elevators didn't work. When we got outside, the streets were ankle-deep in broken glass. You never saw such a mess in your life. Mom nudged me and hissed, "She's never been to San Francisco. She's never been west of Denver. I've heard her say so." "Incredible," the anchor said. "Truth's stranger than fiction," Great-grandma said, smoothing her sheet. "And you never think back about it?" Great-grandma shrugged her little fuzzy pink shoulders. "I've been through too much. I don't have time to remember it all." "I was on the Hindenburg when it blew up, you know." Mom moaned, and the cameraman was practically standing on his head for a close-up. "The Hindenburg? That big gas thing the Germans built to fly over the Atlantic Ocean. It was called a Zeppelin. Biggest thing you ever saw. 5 city blocks long. It was in May of 1937, before your time. You wouldn't remember. My husband and I were coming back from Europe." "No, wait a minute." Great-grandma cocked her head and pondered for the camera. "My husband was dead by then. It was some other man. Anyway, the two of us were coming back on the Hindenburg. It was smooth as silk. You didn't know you were moving. When we flew in over New York, they stopped the ball game at Yankee Stadium to see us passing overhead." Great-grandma paused, caught up in the memories. "And then the Hindenburg exploded," the anchor said, prompting her. She nodded. "We had no complaints about the trip till then. The luggage was all stacked, and we were coming in at Lakehurst, New Jersey. I was wearing my beige coat. Beige or off-white, I forget. Then, whoosh! The gondola heated up like an oven, and people peeled out of the windows. We hit the ground and bounced. When we hit again, the door fell off, and I walked out and kept going. When they caught up to me in the parking lot, they wanted to put me in the hospital. I looked down and thought I was wearing a lace dress. The fire had about burned up my coat. And I lost a shoe." "Fantastic," the anchor breathed. "What detail." Behind him, the woman reporter was scribbling away on her pad. "Never," Mom muttered. "Never in her life." "Ma'am, you are living history," the anchor said. "In your sensational span of years, you've survived 2 great disasters." "3. Great-grandma patted the bow on her head. "I told you I'd been married. And before we leave this venerable lady," the anchor said, flashing a smile for the camera, "we'll ask Mrs. Breckenridge if she has any predictions for this new 21st century ahead of us here in the dawn of the millennium." 3 or 4 predictions," Great-grandma said, and paused again, stretching out her airtime. "1, taxes will be higher. 2, it's going to be harder to find a place to park. And 3, a whole lot of people are going to live as long as I have, so get ready for us." And with those wise words, the anchor said, easing off the bed, "we leave, Mrs. B." "And 1 more prediction," she said. "TV's on the way out. Your network ratings are already in the basement. It's all websites now. Son, I predict you'll be looking for work." And that was it. The light went dead. The anchor, looking shaken, followed his crew out the door. "When TV's done with you, they're done with you." "Is that a wrap?" Great-grandma asked. But now the woman from the suburban paper was moving in on her. "Just a few more questions, Mrs. Breckenridge." Where are you from? Great-grandma blinked pink-eyed at her. The Glenview Weekly Shopper. You bring a still photographer with you? Great-grandma asked. Well, no. And you never learned shorthand either, did you? Well, no. Honey, I only deal with professionals. There's the door.